letter he read to Aiden's family, Lamon Pierce says he knows their pain, losing an infant child of his own.
Aiden's mom says Pierce's actions prior to his arrest speak louder than his words today. KETV News Watch 7's Christina Engdahl is back from Lancaster County Court and joins us live.
And Adrian, Jennifer Brock says Lamon Pierce skipped town instead of turning himself in. His sentence, less than a year in jail and a $500 fine. But Jennifer says no amount of prison time is going to make her family whole again.
We can't move on without him. He was our family. It's like taking the foundation out from under a house.
A house that 2-year-old Aiden Curry made a home. A little boy that still means everything to his mom.
We're happy that this part is over. But I'm supposed to be planning a 5-year-old birthday party today.
Aiden would have been 5 on February 20th, but a 2011 car accident took his young life when a semi driven by Lamon Pierce hit the family car. In January, a jury convicted Pierce of motor vehicular homicide.
We're thankful that he's serving time and doing justice for Aiden.
But before his sentence, Lamon Pierce read a letter apologizing to Aiden's family, saying, quote, none of us are perfect, and I have not been a threat to anyone. He says if he could have done anything to prevent the accident, he would have. But they're words that are far from comforting for Jennifer Brock.
Hearing him say those words just made my skin crawl.
Jennifer says Pierce's words only proves he has, quote, no remorse, and says standing here years after her son's death, she still hasn't found closure.
I'm not supposed to be here listening to the man who killed my son tell me how he understands how I feel and that he's doing his best to make it better. It's disgusting.
Now, Pierce even says he waived extradition to his home state, Delaware, to help give Aiden's family closure, but he'll have to head back there after his 300-day sentence for parole violations. He served jail time for second-degree murder and wasn't supposed to be driving across state lines. Back to you.
Christina, thanks.